Ferrovial has unveiled its Horizon 24 plan in order to update its strategy for the next 5 years and adopt a renewed operating model. In this lengthy conversation, Ferrovial CEO Ignacio Madridejos discusses details of the plan, the current industry situation, the company's strategy, the role of its business lines, main markets, key figures, and a more agile, efficient, and innovative organization model.
Every year, we review our strategy, and it is a bottom-up exercise. And out of a previous exercise, we took the decision to focus on the developing and operating sustainable infrastructure and the sale of the service division. This year is a new exercise, and you are going to see the result of that exercise. What we are seeing is a change in demographics, more population living in large cities, mega cities, and also an older population. We are seeing changes in technology, with the digital technology, online sales, that could be at 25% of the US sales in 2030. We are seeing new technologies like artificial intelligence, 5G, huge investment in autonomous cars that are bringing a changes in mobility, mobility as a service. We'll see, because of all these, 3 billion more cars before 2050. And we have to do all these changes with sustainability, fighting against climate change with a reduction in the CO2 emissions and also with a problem of water scarcity. All this translates into huge investment, $3.7 trillion per year in the next years. I think Ferrovial has a great opportunity to lead this infra industry. I think we are in a great industry, an industry in which Ferrovial can contribute developing and operating innovative, sustainable and efficient infrastructure. And we do it with our values of respect, collaboration, excellence, innovation, and integrity. We have defined four main strategic priorities. The first one is about our people. It's about protecting them with health and safety. It's about also attracting the best talent, and it's about motivating them. We have also defined a strategic priority about sustainable growth in developing and operating sustainable infrastructure, in toll roads and airports, rotating at the same time the assets and exploring new opportunities. We have defined a third strategic priority about operational excellence. It's about improving our processes, reaching efficiencies to increase the revenue from our assets, and also reducing our environmental footprint. And also a fourth strategic priority about innovation, about disruptive innovation in our corporate level, and about incremental innovation in our business units, and all without a sponsor and with a return. In toll roads, what we want to do is to develop infrastructure with high concessional value. Our good example of that is our managed lanes in the US, but at the same time, we can do other type of projects, traffic risk, and normal traffic risk, or even availabilities. And the pipeline that we have of these type of projects is close to 10 billion euros. Of course, we want to increase that pipeline, and we will explore also new geographies in which we have capabilities. What we have in the toll road business is great assets. We have a huge dividends from the 407, the managed lanes, and we need to make sure that we extract the maximum value for these great assets. In airports, what we want to do is to leverage the capabilities that we have developing and operating these infra assets. Of course, as usual, we will continue rotating when needed the assets. We'll look for partners, we work usually with partners, and at the same time, we'll expand the geographic scope compared to the toll concession business. But always trying to extract value, leveraging our capabilities that we have. Of course, in the case of Hydro, there is a good opportunity with the third runway, but at the same time, I mean, we have to follow closely the decisions by the regulator. In the case of construction, it's a capability that we need to develop infra assets with high concessional value. What we need to develop these local capabilities in certain markets. We have defined these markets: Spain, UK, Poland, Canada, US, Colombia, Peru, and Chile. These are our core markets in which we are developing these capabilities. The size that we want to have in terms of revenues is between 5-6 billion. That we move to 6 billion is only if we increase our internal projects, infra projects, because we don't want to have more or less between 25 and 30% of our revenue to be internal. We need to continue working in developing these capabilities, especially design, technical capabilities, but also the capabilities related to bidding and to control of the assets, and all this to make sure that in construction, our margin are at least 3.5% of EBIT. We are exploring new infra-related opportunities. No? One of them is mobility, that is very close to our toll road business, a lot of data and information about the change of behaviors of the users of the toll roads. And we are focusing on the car sharing and a mobility platform called Wondo. We are also exploring electrification. And in this case, we are looking at the limited equity contribution, rotating very fast the assets, and mainly in Latin America. In the case of water, we have construction capabilities in Cadagua, and what we want to do is try to get some additional value being part of the concession in some of the water infra projects. For each of the strategic priorities, we have identified main KPIs. In the case for people, for instance, we have identified the incident rate of severe and fatal incidents that we want to reduce 10% every year. In the case of sustainable growth, we look at the TSR, total shareholder return. We want to be on the top of our industry, and also activity cash flow. We have defined an amount for this period. In the case of operational excellence, for instance, we want to increase or improve 11% of EBITDA every year. As mentioned before, in the case of construction, 3.5% of EBIT. We have also defined an indicator about the reduction of our CO2 emissions that in this period of time we want to reduce by 19%. And also in the case of overhead expenses, we have defined a goal to reduce them by 50 million euros. In the case of innovation, the fourth strategic priority is mainly about 100% of the projects with a sponsor and all of them with a return. We have defined a new operating model to be more agile, more efficient, and more innovative. And we want to maintain the same level of accountability, entrepreneurship, and innovation that we have today, but we want to enhance the collaboration, the transparency, the efficiency, bringing especially digitalization and automation. With these principles, the main changes that we are taking are related to a new service center for finance and human resources for the administrative part of human resources. We are also integrating all communication in one department, internal and external. We are also creating a new business unit of mobility, and also we are creating a unit of sustainability in the company. Also, we are reviewing all non-personal expenses to reduce overhead cost, and we'll try whenever it's possible to relocate employees to be in the same place to increase collaboration. With that, we expect to get savings of 50 million euros per year. And with that also at the same time, we'll be a more agile, more innovative, and more efficient company. We are in a great industry in which we can contribute, and we contribute developing and operating sustainable, efficient, and innovative infrastructure. And we do in a few countries that we have selected, that we have the capabilities, the developing capabilities for these infra assets. And we do it improving and being more efficient, increase of 11% of EBITDA every year, be more sustainable with a reduction of our emissions of CO2 and being more efficient and agile with a new operating model. And we do all this with the same passion to create value for our shareholders.